Hello guys, welcome back to another video. So in this video, we will be discussing about 10 common mistakes done by every drone pilot. So the people who are planning to purchase this drone and who already own this drone must watch this video till the end and should be aware about these mistakes. So without wasting much of the time, let's quickly get into the video. So the first common mistake is take off from dust-free area. So whenever you are taking off your drone, don't place your drone in any dusty area. Like if there is any sand or if there is any dust, there's a high chance that it may enter your gimbal. So stop placing your drone in dusty areas while taking off, and even avoid placing your drone in any grass area for takeoff. This may damage your propeller as well as camera gimbal. If dust enters your camera gimbal, in DJI Fly app, you start getting an error message as gimbal overloaded. So avoid placing your drone in any dusty areas. So the best way is you can take off your drone from any flat surface like any box, or you can use a drone helipad. If you don't want to carry the helipad, then you can take off from any cardboard, or the best solution is taking off from the hand. Taking off drone from the hand is one of the best method to take off. Second common mistake is landing on hand during strong wind. So whenever there is a high wind and your drone is drifting around, so don't try to land it on your hand, because there's a high chance that it will land somewhere else and your fingers may get stuck into the propellers. So whenever there is a strong wind, prefer landing it on some flat surface or land. The third common mistake is forgetting to set a signal loss setting. Go to settings, in safety section, scroll down. At the bottom, you get advanced safety settings. Over here, you get a signal loss setting. So you need to set it to return to home. So when you purchase a new drone, by default it will be set to hover, so you need to change it to return to home. So if you do this setting, whenever you fly your drone and if you lose any connectivity, then your drone will return back to the home point. Fourth common mistake is not monitoring battery status. So I have heard most of you guys have lost your drone just because not monitoring your battery. So whenever you guys are flying your drone, you should keep monitoring your battery backup. So during your flight time, you will get the orange bar and red bar according to your distance traveled or height traveled. So the orange bar means with that battery backup you can return to home. So in the same way, red bar means whenever your drone is flying in any distance or any area, it will forcefully land in same area. If you are over a water, then it will directly land onto the water and your drone will be lost. So make sure you will be actively looking at the battery backup while flying your drone. Fifth one is avoid flying your drone backwards. So most of you guys think that if you're flying in forward direction and if you're reaching to some distance and if you're just coming backwards, you'll be reaching the same point, but that's not true guys. Mini 2 is not that stable and keeps on drifting around a feet. If the drone is not visible to you guys, then don't get your drone in backward direction. So there is a high chance that it may hit a tree or any wire and get crashed. So the best practice is turn your drone towards your side or the direction in which you are flying and fly in that direction so that you will get to know if any obstacles are ahead. Sixth mistake is don't fly your drone with gimbal cap. So most of you guys, when you do some test or when you just want to test something on the drone, so like if you want to operate it just for a minute or somewhere, so you guys keep the cap onto the drone and you operate it and test it. So it's totally wrong to put your gimbal cap when you turn on your drone. In this case, drone tries to stabilize the gimbal and unfortunately, as it will be in the gimbal cap, so it cannot move itself, and there the motor threads will be heated up and there's a high chance that gimbal cable will get heated up and get damaged. So if you're doing this, stop it right now, and if the gimbal wire gets damaged, then it will cost you around 3000 rupees. Seventh mistake is put your camera cap properly. So as we all know that gimbal will be one of the delicate part of the drones. So whenever you are putting the camera cap, put it properly. If you did not put the camera cap properly, there's a high chance that gimbal calibration may get disturbed, and there's a high chance that you will start getting the error as gimbal overloaded or gimbal stuck. So to keep your drone gimbal healthy, place the camera cap properly. Eighth one is never ignore the strong wind warning. So till now, if you guys are ignoring the strong wind warning, then Stop it and be conscious about strong wind warnings. If you guys are getting a strong wind warning, try to descend your drone or keep a drone in your controlled area, and also switch your drone to normal mode while operating. There's a high chance that drone will drift in the direction of the wind, and also there is a chance that you may lose the connectivity. 9th one is, be aware about the obstacles while using quick shots. As we all know, DJI Mavic Mini or Mini 2 won't come with any obstacle sensors. So we should have a proper idea in which path our drone will fly, and we should also check out if there is any obstacle in the way of drone fly. So in case if you guys did not check out any obstacle, and if you activate the quick shot and if any tree or if any pole is in between the way of the drone, then there is a high chance that it will hit the drone and your drone will be crashed. 10th one is, adjust RTH height before using return to home option. So most of you guys are aware about this, and you change your RTH altitude based on the surrounding. So this one is for few guys who won't change the RTH altitude while using RTH option. So guys, if you are using RTH option, manually adjust your RTH to height based on the surrounding, like 80 meters or 100 meters. So when you use the RTH, the drone will automatically fly to the manually set height. From there, it will return to the home point and land over there. So with this, your drone will never crash while returning to home. So that's it for this video, guys. These were the most 10 common mistakes everyone does. So I hope you have liked this video and found this video informative. If you guys found this video informative, do hit a like button and subscribe to my channel. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.